the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit, but my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty.
Was right down from the trolley tracks, crossed from the laundromat, through big shining floors in granite pillars old St. Louis is famous for. I found two songs. But not till after months of Cajun Kitty, Pippi Longstocking, Christopher Robin, Eddie Haywood, and a Pooh Bear. In the children's room, only pioneer girls and magic rabbits and big city white boys. I knew I wasn't supposed to, but I ran into the adult reading room and came across Toussaint, my first black man. I never counted George Washington Carver because I didn't like peanuts. Still, Toussaint was a black man, a Negro, like my mama say, who refused to be a slave. And he spoke French and didn't allow no white man to tell him nothing. Not Napoleon, not Maximilian, not Robespierre. In the summer contest for who colored child could read 15 books in 3 weeks, I won. And raved about Toussaint at the afternoon ceremony. Was disqualified because Toussaint belonged in the adult reading room. And I cried and carried dead Toussaint home in the book. He was dead, but living to me, because Toussaint and them, they held the citadel against the French with spirits of old dead Africans from out of the ground. Toussaint led they army of zombies walking cannonball and shooting spirits to Brehaven. And they wasn't slaves no more. Toussaint L'Ouverture became my secret lover. At the age of 8, I entertained him in my bedroom with a flashlight underneath my covers way into the night. We discussed strategies on how to remove white girls from my hopscotch games, and etc. Toussaint L'Ouverture was lying in bed with me the night I decided to run away from my integrated home, integrated street, integrated school. 1955 was not a good year for little black girls. Toussaint said, "Well, let's go on to Haiti." And I said, "Well, all right." And packed some very important things in a brown paper bag so I wouldn't have to come back. Then Toussaint and I took the Haudiomont streetcar down to the river. Last stop, 15 cents. Because wasn't nobody could see Toussaint except for me. We just walked all down through North St. Louis where the French settlers used to live, in tiny brick houses all huddled together, with barely missing windows and shingles uneven.